if you're watching this video, it probably means you are in pain. And you have probably tried everything to get relief. Massage, stretching, strengthening exercises, acupuncture, and maybe a chiropractic adjustment. And maybe you got temporary relief, but you're still in pain. Hello, my name is Gary Kaufman, and I'm a certified neuromuscular therapist specializing in strain counter strain technique in Santa Monica, California. In my private practice, I see patients every day who are in chronic pain, lower back pain, arm pain, neck pain, and leg pain. Everyone assumes that because the location of their pain is in the muscle, then it must be the muscle that's causing the pain. But is the muscle really the source of the problem? Or is it something else? What most people don't know is that muscle pain can actually be caused by a dysfunction in another part of the body, in the nervous system. And if you fix the dysfunction in the nervous system, the muscle pain stops. To understand how this works, you need to understand the relationship between three parts of your body: the nervous system, the muscles, and the bones. First, let's talk about the bones. We all know that a bone cannot move on its own. A bone can only move when it is pulled by a muscle. And we know that muscle cannot move on its own either. Before a muscle can stretch or contract, it has to first get a signal from the body's nervous system. It's the nervous system that controls the muscular system. It also controls every other system of the body, every second of your life. But in the case of the muscles, the nervous system is the boss, and the muscles are the employees, and they will do what the nervous system says to do. So, when all is well and you are moving normally throughout your day, you will not experience pain. The central nervous system, over which we have control, is instructing your muscle to stretch or contract normally. But if your muscles become overworked, or overstretch, or you are moving too fast, the body will automatically begin to protect itself. This process is known as the protective muscle spasm reflex. Basically, the autonomic nervous system, which is the body defense mechanism, takes over and sends signals to the muscle to freeze. At this time, the muscle locks in contraction and stops moving. The muscle is locked in a spasm, and it's the autonomic nervous system that made this decision to freeze, not the muscle. The situation can be very painful, and it doesn't usually get better without treatment. As long as the nervous system sends signal for the muscle to freeze, the spasm could remain, sometimes for years. Imagine that this ball is the muscle. The muscle has been overworked, overfatigued, and it sends the distress signal, it's called the alpha signal, to the autonomic nervous system. This system perceives the information as a threat. As a defense mechanism, it will send the spasm signal back to the muscle. And then the muscle is in spasm. As you can see, it can last a long time as long as the muscle and the nervous system are being fed on each other. And to make things worse, a spastic muscle can create havoc by compressing blood vessels, compromise blood circulation, and compressing nerves and joints. One of the laws of neurology says it this way. The longer the dysfunction, the smaller the function. This means the longer the muscles are in spasm, the less we can do and the less we can enjoy our lives. So how do you get a spasm to release? In my next video, I will talk about a neuromuscular technique called strain counter strain. This technique is designed to switch off the spasm reflex, calming the hyperactivity of the signals between the muscles and the nervous system. And by releasing the spasm, you have taken the first step toward relieving your back pain.